In the last video, I talked about purpose. Vision, purpose, and goals are closely linked, but they're different. Your purpose is what you're about, your mission, what you're committed to achieving. Your vision is a picture of the life that you are creating, and your goals are the steps that you take to actualize that vision. Your vision is a clear image of how you see your future. It reflects your deepest desires and cannot be based on societal expectations or comparison with other people. You're different from anybody else on the planet, and so your vision would be unique to you. It's important to get a grasp of what your vision is so that you can avoid the daily distractions that come up on a regular basis, and so that there's a lot more meaning and consciousness in going about your daily tasks. A clear vision is very important in every aspect of your life. Life exists in multiple domains. There's work and career, there's family, there is emotional well-being, physical well-being, your social life, your spiritual life, finances. It's important to take some time to reflect on the life you want to create in each area. And this cannot be based on what people expect, but actually what you're drawn to at your core, what really reflects the life that you want to live for yourself. Having a clear vision helps you to marshal your energy in the right direction. As Lewis Carroll said, if you don't know where you're going, it doesn't matter which path you take. If you don't have a vision, I would strongly encourage you to create one and to write it down. It's helpful to take it out of your head and into the world by writing it down. That makes it more concrete and makes you more conscious about making it happen. In creating your vision, be inspired, be bold, be audacious. Don't be limited by what you think is possible or the constraints of your immediate reality or environment. The how will come later, but in the process of creating your vision, focus on the what. Really get centered around what is that picture that inspires me that I really want to manifest in my life. An important tool in terms of bringing your vision to life is a vision board. A vision board is a blank canvas. It can be a digital board or a physical board where you put up pictures reflecting different aspects of your vision. You should be able to look at your vision board and really feel inspired and energized by your vision. And you should place it somewhere that ensures you see it on a regular basis, because that really keeps your vision top of mind. It presences it and gives you that necessary energy and fueling to take whatever risks and whatever actions are required to make the vision happen. In my conversations and my work with people, I find a number of reasons why some people just hesitate to create or write down their visions. And you may find yourself in some of these. The first is undoubtedly societal conformity. Some people feel that by putting forward lofty, audacious visions, they would come across as immodest. Modesty is a virtue, right? And so people feel that they may come across as proud or arrogant if they're unapologetic about dreaming big. Your vision is very personal to you. Dare to dream big. You owe it to yourself to have a shot, to give yourself a shot at creating the life that you truly desire in your core. The second reason is that we're afraid. Afraid that we may not have what it takes to make our vision a reality. Perhaps we don't have the right skill sets, the connections, the right upbringing, the finances that are needed. What I would say is that fear is natural, and it's important to separate two things, the what and the how. When you're creating your vision, focus on the what. And writing it down is an important first step in concretizing that. Then you can start to figure out the how. The third is that vision often involves growth. And growth can be uncomfortable. Picturing the person you want to be or the things you want to accomplish in your life invariably gets you thinking about the effort that is required to get there, and that can be daunting. So for example, if you're looking to lose 30 pounds or to get ahead in your career, those are not small feats, and you may start to think about the diligence, the effort, everything you need to mobilize to make that happen. and that can be crippling in itself. And the final reason is the fact that true visualization is not a skill that many of us have honed. And that's why it's important to practice so that we can sharpen those skills and develop that muscle. I would invite you to spend a few minutes every day reflecting on your vision. It doesn't have to be a long time. Even 10 minutes can make a huge difference because it really helps to presence your vision and it propels you to take the necessary steps and risks that are required to actualize that vision.